So today we're gonna be talking about quadrillionaire blockchain derivatives goddess. What is all that? What's going on? What even is it? A lot of you all know that I make content for those in a spiritual black conscious space for entrepreneurs specifically. So anyone can watch my channel, anyone can watch my videos. I do make content for entrepreneurs specifically. So if you go to my description bio area, you'll see that when I started this channel, it is for entrepreneurs, kingdom financiers, but anyone is able to learn information from my channel. With me being an entrepreneur myself, growing up as an entrepreneur in my family, both of my parents running their own businesses, and just growing up in that space of doing for yourself and being self-made, that is how I came to be me. That is how I came to develop who I am as an individual and my purpose here, teaching people about spirituality and business. So a lot of people don't realize that everything goes hand in hand. Everything is spirituality. Every single thing is spirituality. Everything is spirituality. So it's not about how many crystals you have, how often you use sage, how often you light candles, what type of spells you put on everything. Whenever you speak at all, that's a spell. Whenever you do anything, that is magic. So I'm here to help those who believe that they can be a quadrillionaire. What is a quadrillionaire? You take the same measurements of being a millionaire and apply it to the number quadrillion. But we're working on quadrillionaire projects. The pillar of society, the basis of all wealth, is real estate. So because I teach in that arena, it's easy for me to flow with that topic. However, I'm speaking in all realms of reality when it comes to business and investing. If you are more of a person who has a spiritual business where it's more service-based, right? So you may be a healer of some sort. You may be a nutritionist. Okay, what you would have to do is take your spiritual business. It could be tarot. It could be, like, I wouldn't consider having a being a prophet of business. That's more of a specific area of calling. You have to be called to give prophecies. But you can do tarot services for people. I still have it as a calling, and I don't just do services like that unless it's for a specific thing. But you get what I mean, the gist of it. A spiritual services business. You will have to learn how to have services available for not too expensive prices. However, you need to learn how to cater to those who are in higher net worth arenas so that you can charge more and provide more of a service to people who affect more people. So when you take the concepts of innovation and technology, especially with Web3, because like I said, I'm removing myself from social media in 2025 to get back to real life, because now we have a whole new form of internet, and this is what people aren't realizing about Web3. So getting to that in a minute. Incorporating innovative new technology with the concept of being a wealthy person in general, now you have to be able to put into full concepts, what exactly is this? How can I use this? How can this benefit me? How can I pass on generational wealth? Because that's all this is, financial literacy and generational wealth. Amazing things with Web 2. Now we're in Web 3, where it's everything in Web 2, and it's community-based servers. So it's not a worldwide web that everyone can access just at any given moment for any given reason. It is community-based servers. And then they're able to be used in different ways other than just posting stuff onto the internet. So people can have equity in the server. So you have things like governance when you're talking about a token or any sort of blockchain project. You have people who are able to contribute to what is allowed, what is not allowed, what things are coded for, how, whether it's cryptocurrency or entities, are able to be affected by that particular blockchain project. With Marine Liquidity, Fiduciary Flow, Private Equity, and Research,